Okay, we're back. This is gonna be round two of the pumpkin seed bait making. We made a round of baits with the pumpkin seed, 10 drops in one cup, and this is what the baits came out to look like. Right here, dark, black flake, very simple bait. Now what we're gonna do is take this same leftovers. I got the sprues or the leftovers out of the molds, whatever you want to call them. Won a couple of baits that didn't turn out very well. I had a couple of bubbles in them. One that I used. Anyway, so now we're going to remelt this, but add some Plastisol to it to dilute the color. So instead of making another batch and just using 5 or 6 drops, basically we're going to just take the leftovers of the concentrated color and dilute it. And I found that I can probably do this 3, maybe 4 times and get various shades of the same color, which I like, because it gives me the opportunity, you know, on watercolor to use the same color depending on how the watercolor changes, or whether it's bright or dark, or you know, just conditions change. I can still use a pumpkin seed or whatever color and have a light version, a medium, and a dark. So that's what we're gonna do today. Kind of cleaned up a little bit this morning. I'm gonna start heating this up, and a nice morning out, a little overcast. I'm gonna make some baits this morning, and then maybe go out and go fishing this afternoon, take the kayak out, and we'll see what happens. But we'll see how the weather progresses. So one thing that we've got to do is continue to add glitter. We don't want the glitter to get less along with the color. We want the glitter to stay as constant as we can, even though we're doing it volumetrically. So it's kind of a judgment call. But we'll do the very best we can, and we'll go from there. While that's heating up, we'll get the molds clamped up. To me, this is just an expedient way to make baits, because you just, you know, if you're shooting the same molds, and then you should get the same, you know, dilution factor, if you will, based on the amount of remaining out of the molds, the same, you know, in the cavities there, the reservoirs, you just, you know, take all that, put it back in on what's left over, and then you fill it back up and you start over again. So then you get a dilution of the color. But we do want to add the glitter and keep that fairly constant as we can. Get a spatula here to stir with. And that's remelting pretty well. And there we go. Looking pretty good. We'll thin this down and see what happens. A little bit different shade. Pumpkin seed, and we'll compare those here shortly. There's a little bit of background noise, and I apologize. It's the fan. I'm trying to pull some air out of here and get some air movement so that we don't suffocate. We've got some ventilation going. Cast, get a couple hand pours, maybe go out and try to catch some stripers, some blues this afternoon. It's October here in Maryland, so hopefully the rockfish are moving in a little bit. Get the kayak out towards the bottom of the Potomac and fish that area. and see how it goes. Been doing pretty good, catching a lot of white perch, a few other fish here and there, but I'm going to try to move a little further south today and see. That's looking pretty decent. So, let's see what we've got here for temperature. Oh yeah, we're right where we need to be on temperature. So originally, we added 1.5 scoops. So I'm gonna do maybe about 3/4 of a scoop. Just to put a little bit more black in there, stir that in, and then we should be ready to shoot some baits. Yeah, looking pretty decent. See what our temperature is, move off a little bit. We'll hit it just a little bit more, maybe 20 seconds, just to get a good temperature. I like to be a little warmer on these smaller molds, just so that they fill the tails, especially on that little grub and on these thin tails on that little 4-inch swim bait. These angling AI molds, I really never have any trouble with them filling if I've got, you know, a reasonable temperature plastic. And so that's what we're gonna do. We got this going here. Got a few little air bubbles from that remelt and some of those that I fished. But like I said, I don't really worry about that too much because I stick the injector below those bubbles, let them come to the surface a little bit. And we'll go in here and shoot. You can see that that little grub mold doesn't take much plastic. These are from Stank baits, both of these. Angle.
like coloring and trying to stay within the lines. Except that it moves. Oh, got a little wind there. Stream off a little bit. For a little bit, and we'll come back here in just a minute and see how we're doing on these other bowls. Just a little bit of time. That pretty well cleaned. Okay, there we go. Got those out there. Grubs. Some swim baits. Be careful with these tails. That's the only thing I don't like about this. Nice. All of those came out really well. You can see. In a minute, I'll compare them to the other ones. And then we'll do another round. With these. Good-looking jerk baits. There we go. Look at there. Nice. Very nice. So. Put these back together real quick. There. Twin tail swim grub. Need to get some wing nuts to put on here or something. Oh yeah. Very nice. Very nice. Here again, I'm making these at a request. And so I thought I'd give them a variety of color shades, not color, very different, not different colors, but color shades. So. You can see there. Here, let me pull one of the original to compare. You can see there. Really kind of hard to tell the difference, isn't it? But it's just a little bit darker in here when you get them over there. It's just a shade. Just a shade darker. It's easier to tell on the thinner baits. You can really, I don't know if the camera picks it up, but you can really see the difference there. So we'll move on and do one more round of dilution at least, and make another set of baits. How's that? So we'll go to round three now. And get everything ready to go. Injector's ready. And put this thing back together. Our leftovers in there. Oh, we forgot about these. Just pull those out. Pretty nice. Yep, pretty good. Got these right here. And again, oops. A little bit lighter than before. And we'll go from there. Okay. Put that over there. Down just a little bit. I read the WD-40 cleans this up pretty well. I tried it earlier. Yes, it does. Of course, then I cleaned the WD-40 up with some 409, so not too bad. Okay, here we go. We're back here. I'm gonna make one more round of dilution here. Call it a day for this color anyway. And go from there. Okay. It's a little warm in there. Okay. So add a little bit of this. Plastics 212, medium blend. A lot of times when I fish heavily on salt water, especially a little bit more aggressive, I'll use a little bit harder blend sometimes. But got a little wind coming in. Feels good. Okay, let's get this back in there. There we go. Let's get this in here too. We'll add another 3/4 scoop of the black to this one, and this will be the third. So we'll have the dark, the medium, and then this will be what I would call the light. So just so everybody's aware of that. Thank you. probably do a fourth round of this if you really wanted to. Might do that. We'll see. Shoot four different rounds of this. Litter. Call it 60%. How's that? Let's turn it in. That is one thing I definitely appreciate about bait plastics. It does seem to reheat and reheat and reheat and reheat. And it just doesn't change. So, very good there. Let's check our temp. Yeah. Let's give it, hit that by another. 10 seconds. Just get things set up over here. This has all been real time. So we've shot, what, six, four, six, and four. So that's 20 baits. So there, so we did it twice, that's 40 baits in, you know, 30 minutes or so. Anyway, we'll try to get a little bit better angle here for this. Clear the bait for me, the harder it is to pour open pour, especially these small ones. It's really hard to see when it's at the top. Okay, we're done there. Throw them off to the side, zip those off to the side. That get pretty clear there. Need to get a more lighter, not more, but lighter working. We'll work on that for future. Anyway, those are good. Let's see how we did here. Oh yeah. Those are really light. I don't know if you can see that or not, but those are pretty transparent. You had really clear water conditions and you want to use a pumpkin seed shade, I think these would work just great right there. Yep. So let's see. Now if I want to be darker, I can just go back in and add, you know, 6 drops to that and redo it and keep making some darker ones. But, not a bad looking bait there. Yep. Got a few bubbles in the edge there, but that's okay. I just want to show you the original, how dark it was compared to what we've got now. Now definitely the tint of the pumpkin seed is still here, but that's, you can tell how just on the second dilution, third batch, how it really changed the complexity of that and gets you a totally different looking style bait. And here's a medium dark